My name is Christian Albert. I'm from Grand Falls, New Brunswick, and this is my story. 11 years ago, I started a tree trimming business called Five Star Trimming and made lots of money. And then I started doing drugs and made a lot of friends, and then started another business, pawn shop, real deal pawn shop, Albert's Buy and Sell. I'm a businessman. People come see me, and if they come see me, they come as a friend, but to make a deal. Everything was going well. Everything was going great. I had a great life, had a nice house, $1 million view, big parties, beautiful women, just living the dream. I was living the dream. I had it all. You name it. I had monster truck, I had skidoos, four-wheelers. I had all the luxurious foods. We were eating lobster every other night, sniffing cocaine every night, then started smoking it. $300 worth every night. Eventually it came to that point where I needed at least $300 worth of cocaine every night, because it became a habit. I did a lot of drugs, made a lot of money. I wasn't happy with myself. I was disappointed in myself for doing a lot of the drugs I was doing and the people I would hang around with. I was depressed, I was alone, and this was my way of being happy. And then it came to the point I was so lonely and down and out that I would show up from work and I would park my truck in the driveway and sleep in my truck and didn't even enter my house because it was too lonely to live in that house alone. Just to think about being alone and my kids left and the drugs I had done in there and the parties and I grew marijuana in there for 2 years professionally, and I just didn't want to be in that house anymore. I didn't even want to go inside. I was down and out. I was out. It was time for me to change. Then one day I wake up, normal day, and this guy shows up in the middle of the day, and he brings this Bible, and it was huge. I mean, like, what is that, right? So he brings it and he slaps it on the table on my counter, and he looks at me, and you know, he's got his hand on it, looking at me like he's got something good here, right? And I'm like, it's a book, right? Like, just a book, man. Like, I'm good at like making people be like, listen, that ain't worth nothing, right? Because I don't want to pay much for it because I'm business. I got to make some money. So I'm like, yeah, nah, it's just a book. I'm not interested. He's like, oh, it's a Bible. He's like, it's an old Bible, and it's, you won't see very many of these ones here. I said, you know, I'm pretending I'm not interested, but I can't wait to get this Bible, right? He had a knife. I wanted the knives. He had a knife, a Bible, and a prophecy book that was older than the Bible. God sent this man to my pawn shop that day to sell me these knives in order for me to throw in the Bible in the deal. After I made the deal, he told me, he said, don't ever give that away. Keep that for yourself. You should keep that for yourself. And then I said, you know, he was sincere, and I was like, yeah, man, I'm keeping this, you know? Like, I'm keeping it. This is mine. Nobody's touching this. So then I took it, brought it in the office, and I hid it. And then it sat there for a month. And then finally, I was interested. I took the Bible out that same day, and then I started reading it. So it was very obvious that God was trying to talk to me, and he wanted me to read the Bible. So I'm reading this Bible, and I'm using drugs. I was still doing drugs when I was interested in the Bible. I even in my spiritual life, I was still spiritual, still believed in Jesus, but still using drugs. Didn't know the real purpose of how to be a disciple. So I didn't know any better really until I started reading more into the Bible and then realized, man, I'm sinning and I gotta stop this and I gotta change. Then one morning I wake up and I was fed up. I decided to close everything down and go join a church. And I had a conversation with God the night before, and I was going to a church. And on my way there, two blocks before the church, I see this guy serving hot dogs, and he's yelling my name, and he knew me. I didn't know him. I didn't remember him, and his name is Aaron DeMerchant. I had a conversation with him. He told me that they're Harvest House. They're doing this for Harvest House and this and that. And then I cut him off, you know. I cut him off and said, listen, man, I'm struggling. I'm on my way to a church. I don't want to take too much of your time, but I just want to share this with you. I got a pawn shop downtown. I woke up this morning. I'm letting everything go. And I'm joining that church down the road. I want to turn my life around. I've been having such a depressing time. I'm lonely and I'm sick and tired of this life. And I'm walking out of it and I don't know where to go. I don't know what to do. I don't know where to start. And he asked me, he says, why don't you come with us? I was like, yeah, okay. And I was like, how is this going to work? He's like, just come with us. He's like, just come with us and we'll work it out. So I'm like, all right, let's go. And then I got in the van, came to Harvest House here in Plaster Rock. Ever since then, my life has changed. They took me in with open arms, man, just like a great big family, and gave me a place to sleep. We got musical instruments here. We have a great, great people to come here, and very supportive. They bring food. They talk about God, and they helped me grow spiritually and made me understand more about the Bible, made me a good Christian, made me believe, and much more of a believer. And they brought me the light that I'd been searching for and that I'd been looking for all this time, and all this darkness and all this artificial light that I thought I had was the real light, with all this money and these drugs and these women, this fancy stuff and these truck cars, you name it. I had it all. I had a speedboat, went 70 miles an hour, nicest speedboat you can buy. And I was miserable. I was miserable. I could not stand what I was doing. You can't even understand what I was going through. You can't even understand what it is to have all this stuff and not be happy. But without God, I was miserable. I just wanted a connection and a relationship with Him. And here they gave me that. And I realized there are good people left on this planet. And they really want to help you. And Harvest House is a great example of this. And Harvest House has helped me so much. And it's helped so many people since I've been here. And I've seen such grace. So much grace. And people people that at first I would be like, you know, you're wasting your time. But no, they gave them grace and they took the time and been patient with them and helped them and brought them to Christ. And I was like in disbelief. I was like, what? Like, Aaron is so good with it, right? He brought these people to Christ. I was like, man, I can't believe it. You're a hero, you know? He's good at it, you know? He's got a talent, man. Ever since I've been here at the Harvest House, I've been clean. Ever since I walked in here, I made an oath. I made a promise to God that I would try my best to stay clean, right? But it wasn't a struggle. It was really not a struggle. Like at first, it was hard, right? I didn't have drugs, and I'm used to my normal routine. But God took all that away from me. He took all these cravings away, and all this greed and this money seeking and drug, and it took all of it away. I'm becoming a great person and I'm proud of myself. I don't even care if I don't got nothing. On my journey at Harvest House, I met Pastor Michael, and we were invited to Mount Carlton at church, and I was like, yeah, I'm going. So then we went to Mount Carlton and I decided I wanted to be baptized as a Christian. And I was baptized, and ever since then, things have changed. Things have been better. So now, church is very important for me every Sunday. I love going to church, see Pastor Michael preach. And after seeing Michael doing all this, I decided I wanted to go to university for ministering and to study about God and learn more about God. so I can minister to others. People that I used to party with, I would love for them to come to Christ. I would love for them to know Him and have a relationship with Him. They don't even understand how important it is to have a relationship with God. And I know for a fact, if these people were to know God, they would stop doing what they're doing. And they would get cleaned up, and they would find a better life. And they would find a true light, find something that really makes them happy. Yeah. Whoever is watching this video today that's using drugs or lost in the world today or stealing or an abusive relationship or even struggling in life in general, call your nearest Harvest House and talk to whoever's in charge and see what they could do to help you. They are there to reach out to people with compassion to make a difference. And you need to call them. You need to go to your local church, go talk to your pastor, or go talk to a pastor, period, and tell him about your struggles. And you will see that there are people out there that care for you and they want to help you. And they're going to guide you in the right direction. You just need to go. Just get off your butt and go to your nearest church or call Harvest House, Atlantic Harvest House, and you're going to get help. God is good. I'm telling you right now, guys, ladies and gentlemen, if you don't know God, you better go out there and find Him, because, man, you're missing out.
There's hope for the hopeless and all those who've strayed. Come sit at the table, come taste the grace. There's rest for the weary, rest that endures. Earth has no sorrow that heaven can't cure. So lay